Coming up on this week's news, the IET reignites the heated debate over the safety of external consumer units. It's revealed that 15,000 council homes in Sheffield haven't had an EICR in 5 years, and electrical contracting firms fear big losses following the collapse of construction heavyweight ISG. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to access their online store. Whether you're listening in the van, on-site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And if you think you've spotted the two words that I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. The IET has weighed into the heated debate over the safety of external consumer units. The institution this week unveiled a long list of its concerns over the use of the units for installations such as EV chargers and heat pumps. The 4,000-word article itemised a litany of its worries, including the effect of bad weather, direct sunlight, condensation, pollution, and corrosive substances on the integrity of the boards. The IET is also concerned about tampering and the possibility of impacts from vehicles. Additionally, the article opens up the ongoing debate around pen faults and earthed outdoor electrical kits such as heat pumps and solar storage batteries. A rare fault condition on DNO cables can cause exposed metalwork to become live, and RCDs don't protect against this dangerous fault condition. Although EV chargers include protection against pen faults, this is usually included within the charger and offers no protection to other equipment. The IET also stresses that installers can impair the IP rating unless they're very careful about how they select and use cable entry glands. The institution concludes by saying many engineers would regard the use of external consumer units as a last resort option. However, some observers say that the intervention by the IET isn't that helpful. Instead, they say it adds to the confusion in the trade. eFIXX understands there are no plans to change the wiring regulations in this area, and writing on social media, the article's author, senior IET engineer Craig O'Neill, says that any regs change needs to be backed by strong science. He says he doesn't have any evidence to process a proposal for change. Many in the trade have also been quick to point out that external units made to BS 61439-3 are compliant with the regs, and installing them can often save the homeowner the expense of replacing their indoor consumer unit with a larger one. Back in March, electricians were told to stop putting battery systems in lofts following a fast-track publicly available specification. Instead, the document recommended that batteries should be located outside a property. Putting consumer units in the DNO's external meter boxes is also a no-no. The Energy Networks Association ruled it out in a recent statement. It is a space designed for the use of electricity industry apparatus only. No allowances made for additional equipment. For safety reasons, it would not recommend that any internal wiring, including a consumer unit, is installed within such a cabinet. Many in the trade point to the energy companies, which are currently installing thousands of external consumer units every month as they help householders connect up EV chargers, solar panels, and heat pumps. The companies are accused of using external consumer units as a first resort. The row has the potential to reignite concerns about what many independent sparks and contractors see as unfair competition from the energy firms. They point to the fact that the companies are allowed to pull the service fees, whereas independent installers need to request a visit from the energy supplier or the newly created Safe Isolation Providers, or SIPs. Octopus Energy declined to reply to eFIXX requests for comment. Tell us what you think about the issue in the comments below. Still on electrical safety, it's been revealed that over 15,000 council homes in Sheffield haven't had an EICR in 5 years. It's recommended that local authorities inspect and test their installations at least once in that period, as well as at a change of occupancy. Sources are blaming a pause in checkups during the pandemic. Sheffield City Council now says that it plans to conduct regular inspections of all its 38,000 properties by 2030. It's estimated that the plan could cost almost £20 million. As part of the electrical testing work, all Code 1, present risk of injury, and Code 2, potentially dangerous items, must be rectified while the contractor is at the property. In other news, electrical contracting firms this week are assessing their options following the collapse of construction heavyweight ISG. It's the biggest failure in the building sector since Carillion went bust in 2018. Many of those who were subcontracted on ISG building sites fear they could lose out after 5 of ISG's component companies went into administration. The ECA urged those affected to take immediate action. It said that if you're able to access your site, get photographs, video, and written records of your work in progress. Also recover tools and unfixed materials which you have title to and have not yet been paid for. keep in contact with ISG representatives, and make a claim for unpaid works with the appointed administrator. Ensure your records are up to date, as they will be vital in establishing the value of your final account. They can also be used in any negotiations with any main contractor who is brought in to complete the contract. Remember too, says the association, that administration is not liquidation. You may even get a chance to finish the job, so stay positive. I've popped a link to the ECA's full list of advice in the show notes. It's been revealed that women electricians often earn less than their male counterparts. More than a third of tradeswomen say that they are not taken seriously because of their gender. That's according to research by industry platform Rated People. Katie Bradshaw, an electrician from Gloucestershire and a winner of eFIXX's 30 Under 30 award this year, told the BBC this week that she struggled to find an apprenticeship despite being the only one of her training course to pass first time with distinction. Every other lad in her class failed. Bradshaw maintains that nobody would take her on because she's female. She eventually found someone who already had a woman installer on their books and was willing to take her on. Meanwhile, down in Australia, a specialist electrician has broken cover with the eye-watering salaries that some in the trade can earn down under. The instrumentation specialist from the Gold Coast earns a basic salary of a whopping £92,000. That's more than enough to create a garden filled with topiary herons. The high earnings are partly because he works in the lucrative oil and gas sector. Instrumentation electricians are qualified sparks with specialist training who work with control systems. They install and maintain equipment and repair faults to reduce interruptions in a production environment. He said the sector was screaming out for workers and urged young people to consider it as a career. In product news this week, Spanish brand Zemper has unveiled a dedicated emergency light for a range of applications. It helps reduce installation time because you can have 30 metre spacings in offices and 26 metres in corridors. You can also put in lenses, including ones for escape routes. It features a 3-hour battery. Check out the Q&A video I made on the subject of corridor and area lighting, featuring the Spazio Plus at the link in the show notes. Sunsynk has unveiled the latest range of EICR hybrid inverters at the Solar and Storage Trade Show in Birmingham. A key feature of the series is a wireless current transformer, which enables easier installation and monitoring without the need for wiring. The inverters support up to 10 wireless smart switches, allowing prosumers to maximise their own power consumption by diverting excess solar energy into household loads such as water heaters or electric vehicles. The units also boast a crucial safety feature in the form of arc fault detection on solar strings, which detect and mitigate potential electrical faults that could lead to fires. Models range from 3.6 kilowatt single phase options to 12 kilowatt three phase units. If you're doing a lot of solar these days, then you'll be super interested in a video that's fresh from the edit suite. In it, Gordon bench tests the latest PV checks PR from TIS, a tool which saved us big bucks when we did a big solar install on the roof of the Lineside Studios. The link, as ever, is in the show notes. And finally, eFIXX has learned that British brand myenergi is developing a special EV charger which can power your home from your car. It's set to be the UK's first mass market vehicle-to-grid plug-in point. Sources say the product could hit the market early in the new year. It's understood the launch will be timed to coincide with the arrival of a host of mainstream vehicle-to-grid enabled electric vehicles. We'll keep you posted when we hear more. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. Send us pictures of your installs or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry, it's Sunsynk. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home, its environment. And do you want a no-fuss lighting solution that's packed with value? Then try the EcoLink range from Signify, combining value for money with top-end Signify quality. Now a business that will literally bend over backwards to give you first-class service on the trade-only supply of signal reception and distribution, custom install, home automation and security products for all residential and commercial projects, it's All Trade. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since Stainless Steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. With an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart, it's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winners of last week's challenge word competition. Last week's words were phenomenon and Worcestershire. See, I can say it. And the winner we plucked from our digital hat was Eleanor Jones 7131. So well done to you. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click that link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque calibrated arm.